this opportunity to meet the lost events and worship the Lord. Lord, we thank you because of your goodness and your loving kindness. As the Bible says, you sent your Son to save us, not because of our righteousness, but according to your own mercy. And you did this by washing us with the renewal and the regeneration of the Holy Spirit that you poured upon us abundantly in Jesus Christ. And with this grace of justification, we were able to take part and be called sons and daughters, heirs to the hope of everlasting life. Lord, we pray for everyone that will hear today's blessed word, that people will be hearing your word. We pray that you will give them wisdom and understanding of their hearts and minds, so that not all of the words will be wasted from what they hear. But we also pray for everyone who will go to serve you by giving them talents for performing the work that you have done or assigned to them in front of the pulpit. Lord, we pray that your Holy Spirit will always guide them, that their motives will be pure, Lord, based on the love that they have for you. Lord, we pray for our brother Edgar, whom we will use as a messenger tonight. Lord, we will give him the guidance and the leading, Lord, with your Holy Spirit, that only the truth will come out from his mouth, Lord. And with this knowledge that you will give us and teach us, Lord, we pray that you will continue to strengthen us in faith and make us flourish and cultivate us, Lord. Because of this knowledge, we'll be able to know you more. Through your revelation, we will be able to worship you truthfully. And with that knowledge also, we will be able to love back by loving our brothers and sisters. Lord, we ask you to teach us how to respond to your word, so that we will be worthy to be called Christians, Lord. Worthy to be called your children, for always showing the world who your Son is through the imitation that you will do and by the glorification and sanctification that you will do for us every day. We pray, Lord, that you will continue to shower us and teach us and guide us to be humble, to be obedient, to be always self-controlled. We pray, Lord, that with the words that you will teach us tonight, you will make us more fruitful in our walk as Christians. We pray, Lord, that you will not only bless the people who are here now, but also our brothers and sisters who are not able to make it. And we pray, Lord, that you will build up this church to everyone who is here. And we pray that you will always give us the blessing of participation in the work that you have assigned to us, so that we will be able to pray faithfully, to read the Bible with passion, and to have fellowship with each other, strengthen each other, encourage each other with love. All of this we ask for your glory, because we ask it in the second name of your own Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit consists of all goodness, righteousness, and truth. And find out what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the fruitful for the fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them. It is shameful even to mention what the disobedient do in secret. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible, and everything that is illuminated becomes the light. This is why he said, "Wake up, sleepers, raise from the dead, and the Christ will shine on you. Be careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil." That is the word of the Lord. Thank you.
Once again, Lord, yung kalagayan ng oras na pinahiram mo sa mga buhay, Panginoon, sa mga mundo. Salamat, Panginoon, na nakilala ka namin bilang Panginoon namin, ang Savior namin, Lord. Lord, help us and remind us na magamit namin, Lord, yung bagong time na ito na binigay mo sa Panginoon with the purpose and intention to serve you, to prioritize you, to serve others, and to be a blessing, Lord, sa lahat ng katawan na pagkakas sa amin. Mag-i-bless kami more on your kingdom, Lord, than to this world, Lord. Mag-i-focus na ng Panginoon ang mas higit ang spiritual things at ang eternal things, Lord God, rather than those temporal things, Lord God. Focus mo pa kami isipan na ikaw pa maging priority ng sa mga buhay, na mas lalo namin bigyan pansin, Panginoon, at alam namin na ang oras ng mundo ito ay masama na masama. We need to be vigilant and wise, Panginoon, sa paggawa ng transition sa buhay namin, Panginoon. Whatever the decision that we're going to make, Lord, may it be wise and according to your will, Lord God, that you will give us wisdom, Lord, na magamit namin ang barang tayo na ito wisely sa buhay namin, Panginoon. Salamat, Panginoon, for reminding us once again, Lord, sa iyong salita. Salamat, Panginoon, for letting us know na maraming pa kami mababagay, Panginoon, dapat pag-ayusin sa buhay namin, Panginoon, na nasasayang sa oras na kinagalap sa under na sana magagamit namin para basta na pamagalhati at mabigyan ng kaluguran sa pinagawa namin sa araw-araw. Tulungan po kami, Panginoon, na mabago namin ang mabagay na ito, Lord, at magamit po kami for the glory of your name sa lahat ng ito, Panginoon. Salamat, Panginoon, na maging focus ka namin kalagi, Panginoon, na higit pa sa mga mabagay sa mundo ito, lalo na pagpunan ng pagsin ng mga bagay na eternal sa buhay namin. Salamat, Panginoon, for reminding us once again, Lord. Make us a blessing, Lord, sa aming mga mahal sa buhay, sa aming mga kaibigan, sa aming mga co-worker, Panginoon. Every people that surrounds us, Lord, na makikita ang karanihan mo bilang mga tao sa mundo ito bilang maraming mga kaibigan. Salamat, Panginoon, sa iyong papuri at mga masamang dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus.
Amen.